as I don't think the political space is there for him to conduct the kind of land reform that Arbenz's government did, you know, leading up to the 1954 coup. But Colom, that's where his support is. He used to run FONAPAS, which was an institute that was responsible for helping Indians and rural people to gain possession of land, even in, you know, the Guatemala, that you know, the repressive Guatemala of the recent past. That's why he had, one of the reasons he had so much support in the Highlands, and I think he's very sincere in his desire to do everything he can to get more land into the hands of Guatemala's, you know, Guatemala has probably one of the most unequal land distribution rates in the hemisphere. It easily does. And I think that he's going to hopefully push the envelope as far as he can in that respect. And he certainly owes the Mayan population in Guatemala everything. They gave him his presidency, so I would feel a great obligation to give as much back as he can, and this is one way to do it.
Francisco Goldman, I want to thank you for being with us. Acclaimed Guatemalan American novelist, now has written his first nonfiction book. It's called The Art of Political Murder: Who Killed the Bishop? Francisco Goldman speaking to us from Houston, where the new vice president of Guatemala, the well-known cardiologist, Dr. Espada, now the vice president of Guatemala, has run his practice. This is Democracy Now!, democracynow.org, the War and Peace Report, as we turn to